I always tell myself that sometimes going into a movie with little to no knowledge can actually be a fun thing, because that movie may very well end up being a welcoming surprise. But then there's movies like Hypnotic that remind me of why I need to stop doing that as frequently as I do. So Hypnotic is a brand new action thriller directed by Robert Rodriguez, and the film stars Ben Affleck, Alice Braga, and William Fichtner. So the film is about a detective who goes on a mind-bending journey to save his missing daughter and to put an end to the secret government agency behind it all. Now this movie, let me start with the pros, and that's with Ben Affleck and Alice Braga. I thought their performances were good, and you can tell that they tried their absolute hardest to carry this movie. But despite their performances, that still was not enough to save this movie. Now, in this movie, both Ben and Alice, their performances are pretty average. It's nothing really evolutionary. But, you know, they do their best to carry this movie because the entire movie really solely rests on their shoulders. I will say, I actually did like how this movie introduced the concept of hypnosis. I thought it was actually a pretty cool way.
Hey, y'all. Sorry for the interruption. But I realized that while editing this, I was saying the phrase hypnosis wrong. I was calling it hypnosis. In my head, I was saying hypnosis, but obviously in the video, I wasn't. So I just wanted to call that out real quick before anyone else in the comment section did that. Yes, it is pronounced hypnosis, not hypnosis. And yeah.
The idea of saying certain code words or certain statements in order to manipulate the human brain and getting humans to react to imaginary environments, I thought was actually kind of cool. However, despite how cool it was, there is a giant gray area that came along with that. For example, if I say it is very hot outside and that person reacts to the imaginary hot weather, my thing is, does that person still react to that imaginary environment until I say stop? Or do they keep reacting, or do they just, does it like cool down on its own? You know what I mean? There's a gray area in there, and I don't think the movie really illustrated that properly. This movie has a very convoluted plot. This movie introduced this secret evil government agency, but it really has me asking, are you telling me there's no one out there outside this agency that knows that they exist? Because I find it very hard to believe. You're telling me that if I say these code words to someone and they react the way I do, do they just automatically forget right after that? I don't think the movie really illustrated that. Or maybe they did, I just don't remember.
you see what I did there? You know, brother, manipulation, mind. I'll
shut up. And the movie tries to explain the concept of this power and the entire secret government agency all within the third act. And it ended up just being one big ass exposition dump. You know what I mean? And I don't like that. I don't like when movies do an entire exposition dump on their audiences with useful information that could have been really relevant 2 acts ago. This movie is rushed and you can feel it. This movie is only an hour and 30 minutes, but if this movie was at least an hour to 45 to maybe an hour and 55 minutes to 2 hours, it could have worked out better. And this movie has some predictable moments. Now, I will admit, in the third act where they do like the plot twist on top of the plot twist, on top of the exposition dump, I mean, the plot twists were cool, but some of it just, you kind of saw it coming. like there's no way you couldn't have. I also kind of did question the motive of Alice Braga's character. Like, she tries to do something good for a certain person, but the way she went about it was just like, was that really the best choice? Now, maybe I'm kind of overthinking it here, but honestly, I don't think I am. I don't. Also, this movie has bad moments of CGI. Like, this movie tries to go full Inception at one point during the second act, and I just looked at that CGI like, that is actually terrible. In the end, Hypnotic, again, it had a good concept, but if only this movie just had a more transparent execution, I felt that this could have worked out better in some aspects, and if it had a longer runtime, but it just didn't. So plugging Hypnotic into the rank system, I am going to place this one into the negative zone. But yeah, that's pretty much my review for Hypnotic. Let me know down in the comment section below what you guys thought of Hypnotic, if you went to go see it, which you're probably not. But if you did go see Hypnotic, let me know what you thought below. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Did you really think that was the best ending? Let me know down in the comment section below, and I will see you all in the next one.
After working up the nerve almost equal in size, I walked around with the iron for any wrinkle in time. I paid a piece of my mind for every nickel and dime, but never less than a five and never slept on a job. A killer crept on your squad, yet never left the garage, where your guide was close enough to see the flesh of his eyes. Get to the button and press, it's what the message advised. What's the threat behind the message where the testament lies?